today we're introducing two powerful new design features. Let's go into Elementor so you can see exactly how it works. While we load, you may notice the loading has improved. We've made changes, so loading is now faster and more stable. The first feature is Lightbox, and it affects how images are displayed on your site. Let's add an image widget to the editor and choose an image. Don't forget to change the link to media file, or the Lightbox won't work. When you click on the image, a Lightbox pops up to display the image in full view. You can also set the Lightbox for galleries, and then browse through all the images on the gallery by clicking on the left and right arrow. You may recall that a few months ago we introduced Video Lightbox. This way, you can add the same Lightbox pop-up to your videos. Lightbox works by default, but you can switch it on and off by going to this hamburger icon, then click on Global Settings and switch Lightbox on. From this setting page, you can also change the background color that appears when the Lightbox opens. If you disable the Lightbox on the global setting, you can still open a Lightbox for a specific image by going to Image, Content and setting Lightbox to Yes. The reverse is also true, so you can set global Lightbox and then disable it for a single image. Another feature we've added is the ability to customize the play button design. In Elementor, you can add an image and play button to encourage people to click on your videos. When you switch on the play button, you can go into style and change the color and size of the play icon, as well as add a shadow to it. If you have an attentive eye, you may have noticed that we've improved the default play icon design, as well as several other UI control icons. In this version, we've added the option to upload Elementor templates in bulk, using a zip file. Simply upload the zip that includes your template files and they will be uploaded at once. Finally, let's take a look at text shadow. This feature allows you to add stunning text shadow effects to your page headlines, making them more interesting and eye-catching. I have here this heading widget. If you go to Heading, Style, you can enable text shadow. You can then adjust the shadow color, blur, horizontal, and vertical settings. Here are four examples to get you going with WordPress headline text shadows. You have here your basic text shadow. Then if we set blur to 0, we can get a raised headline effect like the one in this example. Blur can also be used to create this light glow effect. By combining distance and blur, I can get this type of composition. Play around with the controls and surprise yourself with other interesting combinations. The possibilities are really endless. I invite you to upgrade to the new version of Elementor, version 1.6. Please let me know which is your favorite feature in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to be the first to hear about new updates and feature releases for Elementor. Until next time, this is Ben from Elementor.